City Commissioners, for the record, my name is Mary Ann Schwab. I serve on the Southeast Uplift Board of Directors, working on the Comp Plan 2035, street fees, housing demolition regulations, and preserving beautiful sequoia trees, 36 inches in diameter, for a few of the examples. Today, I speak to you as a private individual. However, as Southeast Uplift has not taken a stand on this particular issue, today I'm here to specifically to address the lack of adequate outreach to the impacted neighborhoods and to ask you to table this process until a real outreach has been done. Please table this for another 7 days so the public watching this on TV have a chance to write their concerns, pro and con. I want you to know on Saturday, March 28th, my friend and I rang doorbells, talked with homeowners, and hung door hangers on neighbors' front doors. The homeowners we spoke with were surprised to learn 30,000 trucks would be rambling in front of their homes over a four-year period. In addition to the construction challenges, public safety impacts, limited access to site for deliveries and materials removal, worker parking on narrow streets, noise issues, 1,000 pile drivers, truck traffic.
I think you're talking about construction now, not demolition.
I'm talking about public safety as related to the demolition. You can't demolish something without that connectedness, and I'll challenge that law in court down in Salem if I have to.
Okay.
Why were the neighboring homeowners so poorly informed? The BDS public information signs were placed along a busy Burnside Street hidden by berry vines, one at the entrance of the tennis court. Surely there would have been better places to place them. More neighbors would have been read them, and had they been placed near the Max TriMet bus stop or the path to the park's water fountain. But really, no one driving East Burnside stops to read a legal posting. These signs came up pretty short of that city that works with red flashing lights. So what might go wrong next? Cement trucks squeezing down heavily parked residential streets where students ride and bicycles come skateboarding around corners. The door hanger I've attached it there. This is what we passed out on people's doors. We cut and paste what was given to us during the, what did they call that crazy meeting? The sounding board meeting. We were there in October. I called to get copies of my minutes and my testimony so I could catch it here. It's not posted online. There's been a hiccup on that one too. So I'm going to leave you with one thing. Please, please, please keep this open for 7 more days due to the lack of adequate public outreach. I'm requesting that this be tabled. And I want to leave you with a quiet prayer from Native American Indians, Mitchell, Warshaw religious leader. We have a duty to the land in which we live. We all come from the earth. On death, we return back to the ground. In the cycle of life, everything is born, always is connected with water. Water is the giver of life. We have the best there is on the planet. People out there, check out bullrunraver.org. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mary Ann.
Okay. Does that cover everyone who signed up to speak?
That's all who signed up.
Anyone else?